It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Strategist here at Payne Capital Management. Now, as I noted last week, bad news tends to come on the installment plan. And this week was no exception, with more than 5 million people filing for unemployment, bringing the total number of people newly unemployed over the past month to more than 22 million. U.S. retail sales dropped 8.7% month over month, the biggest on record, and industrial production was down 5.4%, the worst slide since 1946. U.S. mortgage applications were down 34% year over year, the lowest level since 2015, and housing starts were down 22.3% from a month ago, the worst monthly decline since the 1980s. Now, in the face of this overwhelming, horrible economic news, the stock market, of course, rallied to a new recovery high, leaving many talking heads on the financial propaganda channels scratching their heads in wonder, causing one commentator to query, how with such overwhelming bad news can the market even start to look ahead? Well, remember the other thing I said last week. Stocks are a leading indicator, and they indicate what the economy will do, not what it has already done. I'm not going to argue that every bit of bad news is priced into the market. But based on history, the bottom could already be in. According to one U.S. strategist, since 1930, we have had 10 30% declines in the stock market, and 100% of the time, when the market recovers 50% of the down move, the market doesn't retest the low. In other words, the bottom could be in. With this week's rally, we have recovered 50% of the recent decline. Now, in his opinion, why this could be the case is because the policymakers in Washington did a really good job of acting quickly. The central banks intervened with the needed liquidity to keep markets operating and tampering down the volatility. Now, whether he's right is, of course, unknowable, which is frustrating and why timing the market is virtually impossible. Fortunately, we don't have to be right to succeed as investors. We only have to be approximately correct. You know, the opposite of exactly right is precisely wrong. Something I think those who panicked and sold everything 20% ago may be realizing today. Now, I started in the industry in the 70s, and over that time, I observed and survived many financial calamities. The savings and loan debacle, the tech bubble, 9/11, the 2008 financial crisis, and Brexit, just to name a few. The universal characteristic of each decline was the market ultimately recovered and recovered to all-time record highs. The cause of each decline was different, but the ultimate result was the same. Now, the difference in portfolio return was really up to you. Those who panicked and sold in any of these declines dramatically underperformed those who stayed invested and rebalanced their portfolio according to their plan. So what does history tell us? Well, it tells us this: simply stay the course, rebalance when necessary, and keep you and yours safe. If you're sitting there wondering, do I have a portfolio appropriate to the risk in this market? Do I have a portfolio that's appropriate to the volatility we're experiencing? Well, why sit there and wonder when you could know? My son, Ryan, and I have over 75 years of combined industry experience of building low-cost, tax-efficient, goal-based portfolios. All you have to do is simply text or call 844-752-6692. That's 844-752-6692, or just simply call 844-PLAN-NYC. That's 844-PLAN-NYC. Hey, this is Bob Payne. I'm the Chief Investment Strategist here at Payne Capital Management.